My name is Dr. Roby Abraham, and I'm an orthopedic surgeon. I specialize in orthopedic surgery and also subspecialize in hip and knee replacements. Robotic total knee replacements, I think that it's always been said that hip replacements are easier to recover from than knee replacements. Hip replacement satisfaction rate probably 95%, but knees a little sluggish. Knees are a little more constrained in their motion. It's more of a hinged joint, so just really flexion extension. More than if you look at a hip, it's just full degrees of motion and freedom of motion with that joint. So I tell patients that doing a robotic total knee replacement is almost like you're seeing the product or the result even before you enter the room or make a skin incision. You know, after we discuss the surgery with the patients in terms of all the risks and benefits and alternatives, we send the patient over to get a CT scan or a special x-ray before the procedure. And this is what really allows us to preoperatively plan and template all the implants to that precise and accurate position. So after taking, the registration of the patient's actual anatomy and processing it with that preoperative image, we're able to now make our cuts in a very precise manner. Essentially, what we planned before the procedure is what we're doing to within a millimeter during the procedure. So we make a minimally invasive midline incision over the knee, get down to the bone, and we realize all the arthritis that's there, and we prepare the joint in terms of getting it ready for registration. And at this point is when we start seeing a 3D model of what it would look like if the bone was already shaved and the implants already in. And this is where we start balancing the ligaments. And this is the key to the whole procedure. If you're able to balance the ligaments, then you don't really need to cut more soft tissue and try to release more soft tissue. You get it all with accurate placement of the implants that you're putting in. So after we have balanced everything, we feed the machine our plan. We are now making our cuts in a robotic assisted way. We still control the saw and we still control everything that's happening, but we do it according to the plans that we've made. And it's pretty precise, down to a millimeter and down to a degree or two of error, which is important. You want to make sure that you can make nimble adjustments as needed. So after we make our cuts, we prepare the joint for cementing, or if we're doing, for younger patients, cementless implants. At that point, we're just putting the implants right in. And it really depends on your bone quality, and we'll talk about that, and I always talk about that with my patients in the operating room, before in the clinic as well. And now we're feeling, and I gotta say, like more than 95% of the time, that's pretty much it. We were not really making any more adjustments because like our preoperative plan, like our clinical assessment after we've registered, the end product is what we thought it would be. And it's a balanced and stable knee. And that's the most important thing for a total knee replacement. Afterwards, we close the incision. We get the patient over to the recovery room. And about 2 hours after the procedure, they're doing physical therapy and they're getting up out of the bed. They're bending their knee, they're walking with a walker or cane, and they actually go home within 4 to 6 hours after the procedure.